hope everyone is well. Ready for episode 4 of Port Wars. Today we're looking at Back to the Future, 1985. It's not one I actually played at all, actually, ever in my life. I played it a little bit, obviously, before I started the stream up. And it's not one I'm going to be completing. I've looked at the a bit of a walkthrough, so I know what to do. The game can be completed in about 10 or 15 minutes if you know what to do. Let's begin. Starting with Commodore to start with, obviously. I'm going to speed it up. There we go. Okay, it seems to default start on level 4. I noticed that when I played it before. I think I'll start at level 1. It just seems to make sense. I think that looks like a difficulty level, actually. So the highest level, what does that look like? It only affects that photo on the right. The aim of the game seems to be to unscramble the photographs. F1 to start the game. So here's Marty. Doesn't look like I can do anything in terms of punch. Okay, she's following me. He's gonna try and kill me. Yeah, I don't have a clue what I'm doing. No, he's trying to kill me. Let's go in here. I know something about getting a guitar, actually. But how do I get it? Oh, there we go, I've got it. Oh, I've dropped it. Okay. Do I have the guitar or what? That Doc Brown there? Can't go anywhere. The guitar there glows up. Am I meant to be standing next to this? Seems to stop the guy killing me. That Biff. Is that your dad? Why can't I collect that book? Great game. Like, well, it's not a self-explanatory game, put it that way. The walkthrough said something about using the guitar and a book. Can't go in there. Oh, skateboard. Can't seem to use it. I've tried keyboard. Oh! One of them buttons worked. Ha! Nice. Essex. Go in here. I've got the book now. Very strange controls. other than that, graphics are okay. Sounds okay. Sure, if you were a youngster and this was, you know, in your collection, you'd get a lot of fun out of figuring out how to play it. Trying every possible button combination, yeah. Game over. Not sure why. Just checking to see if I can find some hints. Just for the control. Default it to level 4, let's try level 4. Doesn't look any different. Oh, dock. Music began. Oh, hello. None of the buttons work. Oh yeah. Okay. There's punch. Pick up items. Control button and up. Oh, I've died already. Start again. Maybe it'll let me. There we go. I don't know, it says it. It's hard to tell if you even picked it up or not. No, I'm not having too much fun with this one. Try punch. Punch this guy. There we go. It's harder than it looks. Alright, that's in decks. Let me get that book. Why can't... Why didn't you take the book? Okay, let's go to the guitar. The only thing I've been able to get is a skateboard suit. Oh, I do have the book. In deck. Okay, now I've got the guitar. Oh. Pretty sure. Yeah, I'm using it. Let's try and go up on the stage. Oh, it's cabling. Give it one more try. I'll try and use that guitar. It says I'm not live, I don't like that. Hopefully I am live. You try and use the guitar, it just drops it. It's not one that goes down as a classic, I don't think. don't know what year Maniac Mansion came out. I prefer that as an adventure game. No, I think I'm just about done with this one. Oh, it's game over again. It's tricky to figure out that. I can imagine before the internet, when this was out, it would have been very hard. Head over to the ZX Spectrum version. I really like the sound to that. Okay, it's not letting me use the joystick just yet in the menu. Again, defaults to level 4. It's odd, isn't it? Okay, I can use the joystick now. I can't go right though, only left. That's no good. So now I've got to figure out the control pads, the controllers on the keyboard. Oh dear, dear, dear. There we go. It's a punch button. Got every button. One more. Alright, there's no fire button on the joystick. Oh, when fire is pressed. Well, it says to use spacebar for keys for fire, so let's stick with what the instructions say. Doesn't seem to do anything. No. I need to figure out what space bars map to. Zero, okay. Again, worse graphics, but I'm actually able to understand this a bit better. Like, I've obviously picked up this suit here. How do I get her to follow me? I'm trying to punch her. I've just given her something. Possibly. Right, let's take the book. This one controls a lot better. Possibly because I'm using keyboard now. Biff. According to the this actually looks a little bit better in here, doesn't it, than the Spectrum than it did. It did on the C64. Raw guitar. It's not a game I really feel like I will ever come back to and finish, to be honest. You know, fans of the movie would have loved it, I think, as a youngster, if you own this, and if you had seen the movie and then you got this game. Oh, I've gone in the shop. I didn't even realise you could do that in the C64. A little Pepsi advert there. One of the main criticisms this game had from reviews back in the day was that it was too quick to complete. Once you figure out how to play it, you complete it and then never want to play it again, apparently. I have to take that guitar somewhere and play it, but not sure I'll be doing any much in walk, much of a walkthrough in this review. But I have to say the graphics are not as good on the Spectrum, but again the playability a little bit better. Yeah. It might be nice to, you know, as part of an adventure game series, to go through and finish this just at least one time. I'd have to have a walkthrough to figure it out. I can't. What am I supposed to do with a book here? Give it to him. He's got a book. Some noteboard there. No. Biff just don't leave us alone. What would I logically do with the guitar? Just get on the stage and play it, innit? Get these people to follow me first. Okay, she's following. Was she punching me? She didn't follow me in here. Right, she's in there. I just dropped the guitar. Drop is the same button as use. But you obviously have to be in the right spot to use it. Well, it's a slightly quicker one than usual for me because I'm going to wind it up pretty soon. I don't rate this very highly. I never give scores out of 10 unless it's 10 out of 10. But it's not great. You may get some enjoyment out of it if you like a puzzle and you want to figure it out. It's going to take you some time. Not really much point in reading a walkthrough just to play through it. It makes quite good use of the license. It's got the music fitting with the music. It's got lots of the characters. A.E. Newman Crack. I'm guessing that was not there in the original game. I don't know. Alright, game over. I'm sorry if anyone likes this game. I didn't give it justice. I didn't do my homework on it. I just tried it out. That's how I'm going to be doing things. These old games, you know, you didn't have the internet to check out how to complete them. So yeah. There are good points to it, as I say, very good use of the license, enjoyable, good music, and if you're in the mood for a sort of a stroke adventure, stroke puzzle game, and you were stuck with just this, you know, you'd probably get hours of fun out of it, but frustrating to start with because I couldn't figure out even how to begin, but next time we'll be doing something with a bit more action involved, got a list of Metroid Port Wars games in the pipeline, some of which I'm just loading my list now. We're going to be looking at Toobin, Daily Thompson, Joust, Running Man, Elite, Street Fighter 2, Pac-Land, Double Dragon, R-Type, Frogger, and hundreds more. So, and that's just for the ZX Spectrum stroke Commodore 64 series. There's lots of other games involved as well. So, see you very soon. Bye.